Hi again, my name is Yusufa and I'm the CEO of AthGene. Welcome to another episode of Genes Behind the Scenes. So today we're gonna talk about vitamin D, and not just vitamin D in general terms, but more specifically how your DNA is linked to your requirements of vitamin D. But first things first, what is vitamin D and why is it even important? Vitamin D is produced in the skin from cholesterol as well as sunlight, and it's very essential for lots of physiological processes such as bone health, your immune system, as well as, you know, your general ability to absorb essential nutrients. So all things considered, I would say vitamin D is pretty important. But here's the thing, some of us require more vitamin D than others, simply because our bodies don't have a good uptake of vitamin D. So for most people with a vitamin D deficiency, the signs can be really subtle and really easy to miss. I mean, it can include things like, you know, just generally feeling a bit more tired, as well as not feeling, you know, like your usual self, feeling slightly down. And you may have already made the connection between, you know, the typical lack of sunlight during, you know, the winter months, as well as a higher report of people feeling, you know, less than their usual selves during these winter months. And that's because, you know, they could be genetically predisposed for having a low uptake of vitamin D. And when you couple that factor, with sort of the general lack of sunlight in the winter months, this could lead to people feeling like crap, to put it in no other way. So it does not have to be this way. There is something that you can do about this. If you're based in Europe, the EU has a sort of recommended sort of dosage of how much vitamin D we should have, people should have. If you're in the US, the FDA has a different recommendation. But there is a recommendation of how much vitamin D we should have, and some of us are not getting it simply because, you know, maybe we have a low uptake of vitamin D, and then some other factors like we're not getting enough from foods, etc. Here's what you can do about this. By simply understanding what your vitamin D deficiency levels are, you could take precautionary measures such as eating certain kinds of foods. Just to give you some ideas, you could eat, you know, fish, some eggs, even fish eggs if that's your thing. And you can also get smaller amounts of vitamin D from other kinds of foods such as chicken as well as dairy products. So in conclusion, if you or someone you care about, you know, have ever felt, you know, yourself or you've noticed that they are less productive, you know, less active, or just overall feeling less than your usual self, particularly during the winter months, perhaps it could just be that you have a low vitamin D uptake. So I would certainly go and get that checked out. Thank you for your time. Again, Yusufa from AthGene, and this was another episode of Genes Behind the Scenes. See you in the next episode.